Hello everyone, welcome again to my math class. Okay, so we are now in lesson number 3. So sa previous video natin, in-apply natin yung law of exponents sa mga expression na merong rational exponent. Now we will learn how to define radical expressions and we will identify its basic parts. So sana may matutunan kayo sa video na to. We'll start now. Okay, so let us start now with the radical expression. Or simply radicals. It is an expression that contains the symbol right here, or ang tawag dyan is the radical sign. Okay, so let us consider this radical expression. So ang pagbasa dito is nth root of a to the m. Yung number na n daw na yan is called the index or the order which indicates the degree of the radicals. Expressions such as square root, cube root, fourth root, fifth root, and so on and so forth. So, yung kapag walang nakasulat na n sa isang radical expression, it is understood to be square root. Okay, remember that. And yung number daw na under, or yung expression na under sa radical symbol is called the radicand. Okay, so kahit ano pa yung nasa loob ng inside the radical symbol, yun yung tawag, ang tawag doon ay radicand. Okay, and also yung m daw is the power or exponent of the radicand. Okay, kung walang nakalagay na exponent, it is understood to be 1. Okay, so let us have some examples. Tell the index daw and the radicand of the following. Let us have number 1. Cube root of 64. So given siya in words or in phrase, i-translate muna natin siya into mathematical form. So, cube root of 64 is the same as this one. Ayan, cube root of 64. Wherein, yung index natin dito is the number 3 right here. So, ang pagbasa dyan, cube root of 64. At ang radicand natin is 64. Okay, so ganun lang kadali yan. Identify the index and the radicand of the following. Okay, so let us have number 2. So this is walang nakalagay na index, so understood siya square root yan. So square root of 16. So ang index nito will be 2, or yung order niya ay 2, and then yung radicand natin will be 16. Okay, so let us have number 3. So, to read this is 4th root of 16x to the 8. So, ang index natin dito or yung order natin dito will be 4. At ang radicand natin, yung nasa loob ng radical symbol or 16x to the 8. Okay, so let us go to number 4. So, pagbasa dito is 5th root of y to the 10. So, ang index dito will be 5 at ang radicand is y to the 10. So, siya yung nasa loob. Okay, let us go to number 5. So, to read this is 6 root of 64x to the 12 times y. So, nasa loob siya ng radical symbol lahat. Which means na ito ay yung radicand. So, ang index natin dito will be 6. Yan yung order natin or the index. At ang ating radicand will be 64x to the 12y. Okay, so let's go to number 6. Wala siyang nakasulat na index. So, understood yan, square root. So, ang index natin dyan will be 2. And then, yung ating radicand ay yung quantity a plus b quantity squared. Okay, so sana may natutunan kayo sa pagkuha ng index and pagkuha ng radicand sa mga following radical expressions. So, next video natin, we will find the roots, square root, cube roots, like that, and also, alamin natin yung mga perfect squares at saka yung mga perfect cubes. So, God bless everyone. Thank you for watching.